This is a pre-built version of the application. So if we go ahead and run it. Now suppose a company's hiring decisions are based on two interviews, and we have data that shows who was hired based on those two interviews, and the score for each interview is on a scale of 0 to 10, and this is the score for candidate interview number 1, and this is for candidate interview number 2. And the candidates to this side of the decision boundary were hired, and those to this side were not hired, and those two candidates were misclassified. And this is the equation of the decision boundary that we discovered, and those are the weights that we discovered. And let's try to classify some new candidates with those two scores. So the probability that this candidate will be hired is this number. So he was classified as 0, which means that we predict that he will not be hired. And let's try this candidate. So the probability that he will be hired is this number. So he was classified as 1, which means that we predict that he will be hired. I will start by creating a new project. And here we will need the full JDK, since we will be doing JavaFX. And we will have two classes, an application driver class with a main method, and a class where the logistic regression logic will be. And let's open up the previous logistic regression project. And we will need to do matrix operation. So we copied the matrix that we used on the previous tutorial. Now, since this is a JavaFX application, we'll extend from application. And by doing that, we have to implement this start method. Now, the data that we will be using is the same as in the previous tutorial. So, each one of the records here is one candidate. So, this is bias. And this is the score for his first interview, and this is the score for his second interview. And zero indicates that he was not hired, and one indicates that he was hired. So X array will contain the data for the bias plus two interview scores, and Y array will contain the label for each candidate, so 0 or 1. And we turn those two two-dimensional arrays into a matrix, so X and Y. And we will pass those two matrices to this stochastic gradient descent method, which will return a matrix containing the discovered weights. So here we initially create an array and populate it with ones and turn that two-dimensional array into a matrix. Now gradient descent uses all the data set each time we do an update, but with a huge number of records and possibly a huge number of features, this algorithm becomes very expensive computationally. Now stochastic gradient descent is when we update the weights one instance at a time, and the calculated hypothesis and error are single values instead of vectors, and the step size alpha changes on each iteration, and the weight update instance is selected randomly. And those were the equations that we used on the previous tutorial. And the difference here is that the hypothesis and the error, which is the hypothesis minus the label y, are both single values. So in the previous tutorial, they were matrices. And same here, we will return a single value from this equation. So this is the sigmoid or logistic method, and it will take in a matrix and return a single value, a double. And let's define the number of times that we will go through the logic here, so the number of iterations. So this is a single value, and this minus this is also a single value. So we get a random number and use it to pick a random candidate and perform the calculation on it and remove it so that we don't pick it again when we do another random. And we have a different alpha each time we go through the loop. And finally, let's define the classify method, which would be the same as in the previous tutorial. So if G of W transpose X is bigger or equal to 0.5, then we predict that the candidate will be hired, so the label would be 1, and we predict that he would not be hired otherwise. So this is the probability, and here we predict that he will not be hired, and here we predict that he will be hired. This should do it for this class. Now here let's define this logistic regression instance that we will be using, and this is the weight matrix and M and B for the decision boundary line, and the weight string buffer is used for display purposes. And let's add this code here. So here we're calling the stochastic gradient descent method, and we get back a weight matrix, and we use it to pick up M and B of the decision boundary, and here we populate the weight string buffer with the different weights, and we call launch, which would trigger a call to the start method, And before coding the start method, let me define this handle command method. And it allows the user to classify new candidates from the command line. And this will be the code for the start method, which is JavaFX code. And the call to the handle command method is made here when the user closes the window. And finally, let's go ahead and test run the application. So we discovered this equation of the decision boundary and those weights, and the candidates to this side of the decision boundary were hired and those to this side were not hired, and those two candidates were misclassified. And let's go ahead and try to classify some new candidates. So this candidate with this score, so this is the probability that he will be hired. So he was classified as 0, which means that we predict that he will not be hired. And if we do this candidate, so this is the probability that we get that he will be hired, and he was classified as 1, which means that we predict that he will be hired.